Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover Standard Deviation Index. Let's start with a definition. The Standard Deviation Index is a measurement of bias, or how close your value is to a target value. In shorthand, you'll often see the Standard Deviation Index expressed as SDI. This is the formula for SDI. Let's pick it apart so that you can understand it. First, we subtract the peer group mean from the laboratory mean. The difference is then divided by the standard deviation of the peer group. Both the peer group mean and SD can be obtained from an interlaboratory comparison report. I encourage you to take a look at our videos for calculating the mean and SD if you'd like additional information. Now that you understand how the formula works, let's practice by plugging some numbers into it. Let's move our formula down to the corner, just in case we need it. Here are values for our means and SD. Let's begin by copying down the formula, and then substituting the values. Next, we subtract the group mean from the lab mean. Finally, we divide. After rounding, the SDI turns out to be 1.3. Now let's do a little practice. The next segment of the video shows a data set that you can use to practice calculating the SDI. Pause the video when the values appear. This will give you a chance to grab pen, paper, or a calculator. Calculate the SDI, then restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here are our means in SD. Remember that our formula is in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The SDI is -4. Here's how I got that figure. First, I substituted the values into the formula. Then I subtracted the group mean from the lab mean. Finally, I divided. Now that you know how to calculate an SDI, let's talk about application. The target SDI is 0. 0 indicates a perfect comparison to the peer group. If you don't hit 0, here are some guidelines that you can use. An SDI of 1.25 or less is considered acceptable. An SDI of 1.25 to 1.49 is considered acceptable to marginal performance. Some investigation of the test system may be required. An SDI of 1.5 to 1.99 is considered marginal performance. An investigation of the test system is recommended. An SDI of 2 or greater is generally considered to be unacceptable performance. Remedial action is usually required. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.